marinade. You can use chicken, you can use any type of beef, you can use scallops, you can use shrimp, you can use tofu, you name it, you can use it. And you can use the same marinade with all of it. It doesn't matter. The other ingredients, simple, easy, and classic. Green onion, regular onion, carrots, mushrooms, and the vermicelli rice sticks that you can find in any grocery store at any given time if you can't find the Korean cellophane noodles. But my point is, you can use any type of pasta noodle, udon, soba, whatever, it's still gonna work. Okay, let's get prepping. First things first is that I'm going to get my steak into marinade. You can let it marinate overnight, 20 minutes, an hour, just marinate it. Just cutting it a little bit in half so that I have some thinness so the marinade goes through it quicker and it cooks quicker. I'm doing it in strips. You can do it any way you want. Doesn't matter. Okay. Done in the bowl. And let's get a little marinade on there. Stir it. And let it sit there for quite some time. All right. You want to slice these pretty thin. Why? Because you're going to saute them, and there's nothing worse than a crunchy carrot when it should be a little bit soft, right? So you want to make sure that you cut it in sizes where you know that they will saute and become tender. That's enough. Next, some onion. Good to go. And my green onions. I like to buy my mushrooms already chopped because why? I'm lazy. But you can, again, get mushrooms that are whole. The shiitake I love putting in here. You can do a blend of mushrooms. All right, that's it. And now we're gonna get to the stove. We're gonna cook off the noodles, saute the vegetables, and get ourselves a delicious Korean japchae dish. Okay, in goes the noodles. And this is a very quick cooking process, so we just might go from noodle pot to fry pot. All right, my fry pot is on, hot, and in goes my meat. Now I'm going to reserve the marinade on the side, and you'll see why in just a moment or two. As soon as my meat starts to cook, I'm going to add my vegetables, saute them off, and then we're going to get our noodles right into that pan, stir fry them, and plate it, and eat it. Because that's the way it needs to be done. And I'm just going to make sure that I have a single layer of beef there, and I'm going to put my vegetables right on top. Just like that. All right, my noodles are just about ready to go. And I like, the consistency of the meat and the vegetables. So we're gonna go straight from pot to pan. Here we go. Oof. And here's the best part. That reserved marinade gets put right on. There it is. If you have a wok, better, even better, because this would be an amazing thing to cook inside of a wok. But if you don't, that's okay, because a big pan works just as well. All right, you want to make sure everything is coated, heated through, and in 2 seconds, we're going to take this, get it on a plate, and take the biggest bite ever. All right, done, good, here we go. Usually I like to mix in my vegetables and meat, but right now we're gonna do it a little different because I'm just a little different. There it is. Okay, some sauce. And there it is. We have Korean style japchae sauteed noodle that has carrots, marinated beef with the Korean marinade, some scallions, white onions, and what? Mushrooms. Now I'm gonna taste this. Okay. Oh yeah, come to mama. Let's get it all in there. Well, I need a little bit of everything, twirly. Okay, ready? That deserves the Hall of Shame dance. Because I just put myself to shame with this dish. This is so awesome, I can't stand myself. The chewy vermicelli noodles, the Korean marinated beef with the mushrooms, the carrots, scallions, the white onions, everything put together.